Good morning, YouTube. Today we're going to head on down to Dakota, and the Scuderia Society is having a track day, but McLaren of Houston is going to let me go test drive a new McLaren 570. I don't know if it's the S or the GT or whatever, but it's a 570. I'm sure it's going to be a ridiculously awesome car. I'm pretty damn excited, so why don't we head on down to Dakota, go test drive this sucker, and see how badass it is. They're trying to convert us Ferrari people.
Yes.
Did you go already?
Holy shit.
Did you get to go on 130?
No.
Now, have you driven McLaren's a bit?
I've driven an MP412C.
Okay.
Let's see on the other side.
I'm in McLaren. I'm assuming it doesn't do anything until the keys.
So if your foot's on the brake?
Cool. Well, that's weird. It starts rolling before you give it gas in this car.
Yeah, I mean, it's got an active vital big time.
So in the, I have a 430 and it's, you know, it won't clutch until you actually give it gas.
Right. Now, are you going on track today?
No. Unfortunately.
Are you just doing camera for other people or?
Well, just for my own YouTube
cool.
stuff, but
oh, cool.
I mean, I certainly know a lot of guys out here.
Yeah. And we'll go left here.
This one's the 570S?
570 GT.
This is the GT. Okay.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a little softer suspension setting than the S. You've got steel brakes instead of carbon ceramics.
Okay.
You don't have the Corsa tire that you'd have on the S. So if you were going to track the car, you'd probably, you know, more people choose the S.
Right.
Just a little lighter.
It's not that this won't do it.
Just a touch quicker. Yeah, exactly. This you can track all day long. Yeah, we're good.
Yeah. The shifts are like that.
Yep.
That's so much faster. Probably don't want to hear this, but I tracked the MP412C and a 458 in the same day, and the 458 was what convinced me to buy the Ferrari.
Uh-huh. Well, that's cool, because that's what it's all about, you know?
Yeah, I mean, everyone's like, which one should you get? I'm like, you gotta drive them, because they have different characteristics. You may or may not like certain ones.
100%. And leave something behind.
Ooh, yeah. That boost kicks in. These are turbo, right?
Yeah.
That's a huge thing. I know that guy, Paul.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Well, as soon as they sent the email out to the FCA, I'm pretty sure half the Ferrari guys were like, we should probably try this, you know?
Yeah.
It's funny because, you know, in like most of the car world, it's always like some brand versus, like Ford versus Chevy, whatever, you know?
Sure.
And there's a little bit of Ferrari versus Lamborghini, but to me, anyway, I feel like if you got a Ferrari, Lamborghini, or a McLaren, no one cares. Like, they're all awesome.
Right.
So that at that point, you're splitting hairs, right? It's like,
well, it really comes down to, you know, your personality, but, you know, are you tracking a car? Or
right,
are you doing
right.
this? Are you doing that? You know, and, you know, we were doing an event in Vancouver, and all these, you know, Lambo guys were just getting passed left and right with McLarens. And, I mean, a lot of them have SVs and whatnot. Had him for like 2 months, and he's like, man, I can't believe this. And I took him out in the 720, and he was just like, oh my god, you know what? I said, you've got a decision to make, right? Do you want to keep getting passed, or what do you want to do here? But yeah, I mean, he had a buddy that had a 650 and another 675 LT, and he was actually swapped cars with these guys.
Oh yeah.
And so he was catching his own car all day long.
Oh, that's gotta
like,
be
I can't take this.
So then it's not a driver issue.
No.
Oh, that's
he's
the worst.
Just like, my car is so heavy and slow. I'm like, yep.
I grew up working on cars.
That's really cool.
So
you know, and that was the best thing is, you know, I buy this Ferrari and everyone's like, oh man, the maintenance is going to kill you. And I'm like, I want to do it myself. And like, you can't work on a Ferrari. I'm like, yeah, you can. It's just a car.
Yeah, I get a lift and I'm good.
I don't even have a lift. I just use jack stands. Holy shit. This is a lot faster than your car.
That's pretty quick.
Oh, this would put my car to shame. RPM these? Holy shit. That is ridiculously fast.
Yeah, I mean, you got...
Well, I'm dealing with 12-year-old technology versus brand new, latest and greatest.
Yeah. Holy, I mean, you know, you're right around the 2 mark, but, you know, by the time you get it the way you want it, you might be in between that 210 to 220 range, somewhere there, depending on what you want to do for options and whatnot.
That's actually not bad.
What you're getting? Yeah.
Oh, it's 7 speed, so you actually can get some sort of mileage.
Especially when you're driving like that, you're gonna get good.
Yeah. Well,
I can
turbo.
Tell you're worried about gas mileage.
Yeah, with my 8 miles per gallon Ferrari right now.
Yeah. Is that on idle?
Yeah. Oh man, when I took it to Dakota, I burned out. So we did 3 heats, 20 minutes each, and I burnt through a little over half a tank. I was like, jeez.
Have you been in one of the new gens?
Yes. I haven't been in the new Cobra, but I've been in the new GTs.
Yeah, what do you think?
I love it.
Okay.
So as the story goes...
You're looking right, man.
Yeah. So I'm a big Mustang guy, obviously.
Yeah.
And...
Yeah, I grew up with a 66 GT, so...
Yeah. What's the warranty on these?
3-year unlimited.
3 years. Jeez.
Yeah. So you can just keep driving... You can just get a fuel truck to follow you around.
I think you're gonna turn me off. Yeah, this is totally it's got a lot of the same awesome things, just amplified and better.
And very refined, very clean.
Like, I mean, everything's so tight, like the suspension's really nice and tight, everything's the steering's ridiculously tight, and of course the acceleration's insane.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Yeah, it's a car you can drive all the time too, you know. I mean,
yeah.
A lot of cars that are great on track, you just, you know, they beat you to death, you know, if you're just in a regular situation.
Yeah, I assume that's more so for the GT than the S, right?
Yeah, very much.
It's my zero.
Here?
Yeah.
Nice.
Zero kids.
No college fund to pay for here, people.
Nope.
It's all going into my playtime. Just a little more forward.
Sure.
Up to that white cone. And perfect. Right there. Okay.
Nice. All right. So
we'll just put it in neutral. Hit the end.
Back.
No. Oh. We'll leave that in support.
That's
the
support.
End here.
Oh, there.
And then I'll have you pull that little flap real just smooth
Which one?
And easy.
Oh, this one.
The one down below. Real soft.
There you go.
See that brake
there?
There
it goes.
Perfect.
Yep.
That's it. Nice and done, sir.
This is badass. Thank you very much.
See?
What was your name?
No kids. You can get this anytime you want.
Shit.
It's Mark.
Mark?
Yeah.
Oop. There he goes.
Well, we're waiting for the next round of the Scuderia Society races, so got a little bit of time. Thought I'd give you my thoughts on the 570 GT. So, test drove the 570 GT. Whew, that is one hell of a car, and they're only around $200,000-$220,000. Oh, I hate to say it, that's pretty tempting, but I don't know if I'd quite consider getting rid of the 430 for that. Partly just because I love Ferrari so much now that I'm kind of entrenched in the Ferrari culture, but there's no doubt the 570 is a better car. I mean, it's just faster, it handled better, it was smoother, everything about it was just a little bit more refined. You can tell that there's a lot of time that's been spent in the engineering of it. It's a one badass car. So my thoughts would be, if you're interested in McLaren and you want the 570, it's probably a pretty good choice. The only question is, how are they going to depreciate? I know some of the McLarens, especially the 12Cs, they've depreciated really badly. I don't know if the 570 is going to do that or not. I know supposedly the 720 is kind of holding its value really good. Obviously, the P1s are, you know, totally different game. And I think the 675s are too new to really know yet, but we shall see if the depreciation becomes a factor on those cars or not. But amazing car, really tight steering, tight suspension, and the acceleration, when it got boost going, holy shit, that was fast as crap. Damn, that was some badass shit. So, all right, well, there you have it. Those are my thoughts on McLaren. Stupid airplane. Over there is the Corvette Invasion. You can kind of see in the distance. I'm going to probably head over there in a little bit, go check out some vets. I'm going to wait for another session or two of the racing over here as long as I'm here. Go away, plane. You're ruining my video. All right, you know the drill. Subscribe. Watch that video. Maybe even buy a t-shirt. Give me the thumbs up because that McLaren's pretty badass. So we'll see you around. We'll do some more car stuff.